gentlemen in the congregation, family, friends, brothers and sisters, boys and girls, good morning. God is indeed our present help in times of trouble. God is our refuge and strength. And family, this morning in the Nightingale Grove Baptist Church is here to remind you, you know, that God is always there. And you know, He's omniscient. He knows that this day would come. And I want to remind you from the Nightingale Grove Baptist Church as we offer condolences to you, to let you know that our God said that He will never leave you nor forsake you. That our God is faithful. Just like how your dad was extremely faithful. I'm sure that will be said about him by others. But I could testify many, many, many mornings. I would see just walking down the hill, walking across, up the hill. He was so diligent in duty. He persevered. He was constant. You know, and he just kept at his task. And even as a church, as I thought of just letting you know that as a church, we continue to pray for you. Because, you know, that strength, you know, the Lord reminds us that we should bear one another's burden. And as a church, as we offer condolences to you, we want you to know that we will continue to pray for you. Sister Carol, God is going to strengthen you. Master, hey, George, I don't remember all it is. But God is going to continue to strengthen you. And our duty is to continue to just tap into His source. Because listen, He's ever faithful. He's a God who keeps His word. He's all-knowing, all-powerful. And let me tell you, every day that we are alive is a day to give Him thanks. And so family, continue every day to give our thanks for God having lent this precious life to us. As a community, yes, we will miss it. As a community, yes, He will not be around physically. But the values that He has passed on will live in the children, the grandchildren, if we continue to apply them to our lives. And remember, we are all living to hear, well done, thou good and faithful servant. And so as a church, as we offer condolences to you, our wish is that every member of the family will so live that just like how your father was so, grandfather, great-grandfather, husband, was so faithful, that God will be able to say to you individually and collectively, well done, thou good and faithful servant. God bless you all.
Amen. Thank you very much. We praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Alright, praise the Lord. I don't want you to sleep, but you know, there's only one person that is lying and sleeping in this casket. All of us is alive and well. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. And we have our first lesson, and this will come to us from Psalm 90, reading from verse 1 through to 12. And this will be done by Conor Blake Jr. Grandson.
Good morning, everyone. The scripture reading will be taken from Psalm 90, verses 1 to 12. And it reads, Lord, Thou hast been our dwelling place in all generations. Before the mountains were brought forth, or even Thou hast formed the earth and the world, even from everlasting to everlasting, Thou art God. Thou turnest man to destruction, and says, Return, ye children of men. For a thousand years in thy sight are but as yesterday, when it is past. And as I watch in the night, thou carriest them away as in the flood. They are as a sea. In the morning they are like grass, which groweth up. In the morning it curseth and groweth up. In the evening it is cut down and withered. For we are consumed by thy anger and by thy wrath. Are we troubled? Thou hast set our iniquities before thee, our secret sins in the light of thy countenance. For all our days are passed away in thy wrath. We spend our years as a tale that is told. The days of our years are a few score years and ten. And if by reason of strength they be fourscore years, yet is their strength labor and sorrow, for it is soon cut off, and we fly away. Who knoweth the power of thine anger? Even according to thy fear, so is thy wrath. 12 and last. So teach us to number our days, that we may apply our hearts unto wisdom. Here is a portion of God's holy word.
Recently, I keep looking at life in a different way. If you study the amount of persons that died in Jamaica, a lot of persons that died in Jamaica is young men. A lot of young men don't live to reach the age of 40 in Jamaica. Now, Mr. Blake have lived to see his grandson and great grandchildren as well. And my friends, my brothers and my sisters, if you are alive, you have a reason to give up thanks. As long as you are alive.
Thank you.
Always come along and ask us if you were in need
of ground provision that he would take from his field nearly every day. He was a very kind-hearted person, and he always wore a contagious smile. The deeds that Master Noel did for our family has humbled me and has taught me that it is possible for anyone to become homeless or in need. And so,
yes,
from that time, I pledge my heart that anyone that I see in need, I will never, ever turn them away. Because the deeds that Master Noel has done for me has always been lingering in my heart. The Martins family again extends their deepest condolences to the Blake's family and relatives, especially Sister Carol and Sister Turner, who was my former co-worker. We have spent some precious time together, and all the other relatives of Mas Noel, we extend our sincere sympathy for you all.
Yes.
Mas Noel, you are sadly missed by us. You are no longer in our lives to share, but in our hearts, you will always be here. Walk good, Master Noel. See you in the morning.
Amen.
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 Amen. You know, you don't have to be rich to touch somebody like you.
Amen.
The simple thing you do,
amen,
can make a difference,
amen,
in someone like you. Amen. 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 Grand and great grandchildren.
I'm very afraid. But I know one of them business I mean, I'm coming to tell you to put in a bank. No,
good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
Thank you all for being with us today to celebrate a life of Grandma Father. Grandpa, we miss you. Rest in
peace. The
investigation, January 6th. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
I
wonder, Marcia Jones, if I share the top with all the camera and all of them.
Is that Marcia Jones, play?
Right, is that Jones? Can you believe?
Hold on. Yes. Yeah. Hold on.
Let me see.
This is Mio. Hi, I'm sorry. This is Marcia Jones Blake. I heard you guys asking about Marcia Jones Blake. Yes, this is trying to log in for my mom, Monica Jones.
This poem is titled "Still Now."
What can I do?
Words seem so feeble in moments like these.
Life is so precious.
such a deed.
The depths of your pain I cannot comprehend, but I will stand alongside you in darkness, my friend.
Love is a bond that death cannot part.
The heart of our heart was still held in our hearts.
Amen.
Come on, give them a round of applause.
Encouraging him to surrender his life to the Lord.
However, he never made a public profession of faith during my time, but I was confident that the seed was sown and one day he would surrender to the Lord. Thank God, a few years ago, under the leadership of Pastor Brown, he accepted Jesus as his personal Lord and Savior. Since then, I visited him a few times and continue to encourage him. You could see the change in him. Rest in peace, my friend, and light perpetual shine on you. I quote from Taylor. Once enjoyed and deeply loved, we can never lose, for all that we love deeply becomes part of us.
Amen.
Come on, if you're going to clap her, give her a round of applause.
Okay, I'll just add my little bit here. Yes. God give it more grace when the burden gets great. Mr. Norman was one thing. Good friends are like real gems, and Mr. Norrie was one of them. He was my primary schoolmate and my neighbor for a few years. I found him to be a true and loyal friend. Kindness and honesty with him was a virtue. He had a warm smile and an awesome, sweet personality. He looked at the people everyone and was never too busy to listen and console. He was firm in his principles, but very humble, always ready to offer help whenever needed. Master Noel, as was affectionately called, was so genuine that the Lord chose a beautiful wife in the person of his Carol for him, who is also one of my dearest friends. His Carol, my sympathy, goes out with you and the rest of family, because most of them was a friend whose memory I shall always cherish.
Yes.
Praise the Lord.
There is a God.
Praise the Lord. This time we'll have a Subvert Smith, family friend. We're going to ask the Bishop of a primary school to get you ready for the
audience. And this is the granddaughter.
Good morning. For me, Mark Noel was a father, a grandfather. When I came to live in my husband was a part of his because he treated us with such love. I am here to represent my husband, Waylon Smith, aka Jagan, who is regrettably absent today. 2 Corinthians 5 verse 8. We are confident, I say, and we would rather to be absent from the body as to be present. Tribute to the late Noel, aka Mas Noel, the man. Only those who are lucky enough to have a wonderful friend. Mentor, neighbor, like Mr. Blake, otherwise called Master Will, but I refer to him as the man, would understand the pain I feel losing such an individual. The man, as I call him, was a very stern but caring and sharing person. These qualities were not limited to his family and close friends, but to the community members and other persons he encountered. My father died when I was very young, but thank God to Mr. Blake. Thank God, Mr. Blake managed to ease the pain by nurturing and guiding me the best way he could as a father. When there was a situation where someone would do me wrong and it was brought to his attention, he would say, "Partner, once bitten shy." This simply means I should never give that person a chance to hurt me again. On a yearly basis, when I am away, my family would receive packages of whatever goodies were available to him. He has taught me many, many life lessons, but one that stood out in my mind is, take care of the banana, and the banana will take care of you. I really live by these words, so when things get hard, as they do sometimes, I look back at those words and use them as my driving force. In the mornings, going or coming from his daily routine on his farm, I could hear him call out to me. In the mornings, going or coming from his daily routine on his farm, I could hear him calling out to me. If he said, "Brother," I knew he was upset about something. But if he said, "Partner," I knew he was in a good mood. On hearing the echoes of his voice, I would answer, say, "Oi, sir," and we would chat and laugh if he was in a happy mood. But if he was not and he said, "Brother, you know so and so," I would try to talk to him until I hear him start to say, "Yes, Father." And at this point, I knew he was calm and we were on the same page. Losing a mentor, neighbor, and a stalwart of the community is very hard for me. But what makes it even harder is the fact that I will not be there to say my final farewell in person. Nevertheless, I will remember him always for his great generosity and wise words of wisdom. He can only be physically gone, but never his life lived and the memory shared. To his wonderful family and friends, my heart aches for your loss. I wish I could take the hurt away. My love and deepest condolences goes out to all. Have faith and be strong. Walk good, my hero. A true legend. Rest well, Father.
Amen.
Amen. Take care of the banana.
Yes.
And the banana will take care of you.
Yes.
And that is so true. Yes. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Bay Sheba Primary School.
Impact he has left,
the legacies, the experiences, and memories that you should forever cherish. Your loved one is not resting. Don't fill your life with tears. Let your memories bring you comfort. Remember all the good years. To our sister, to our colleague, Ms. Turner, just want to say, may God be with you and give you comfort. Wrap his arms around you and give you peace and hope. May he feel his strength and may you feel his love forever and ever.
Amen. This time we'll have a selection, and this will be done by Sophia Theater, family friend.
Good afternoon, everyone. Bless the Lord. I hope as we do this song, it may bless your soul, especially the grief family. Amen.
You may feel down and feel like God has somehow forgotten that you are faced with circumstances you can go through. Right now it seems there's no way out. You're going under. God's proven times and times again, he'll take care of you. He'll do it again for you. He'll do it. Yes, he will do it again. Just take a look at where you are now and where you have been. Has been, you know, you make a way.
know when, you may not know how, but He will do it again. My brothers and my sisters, we serve a faithful God.
Amen.
Faithful God we serve. This time we have our second lesson, and this will come to us from the book of Ecclesiastes, chapter 3, reading from verse 1 through to 12, and this will be done by Blake Mees.
I was one of his closest confidants. He tells me things that nobody knows. Right? Yes. And this is to me just gave one of his favorite quotes, but to me he said, look here, enemies, is not how much your world is, how much your seal. Okay? So I have not that. I cannot afford to save as much as he would want me to save, but I always remember his wise words. I love my uncle, and may his soul rest in peace. Thank you for hearing. The lesson comes from Ecclesiastes chapter 3, reading from verse 1 to 12. To everything, there is a season, and a time to every purpose under the heavens. A time to be born and a time to die. A time to plant and a time to pluck up that which is planted. A time to kill and a time to heal. A time to break down and a time to build up. A time to weep and a time to laugh. A time to mourn and a time to dance.
Yeah.
A time to cast away stones and a time to gather stones together, a time to embrace and a time to refrain from embracing, a time to get and a time to lose, a time to keep our ends and a time to soar, a time to keep silence and a time to speak, a time to love and a time to hate, a time of war and a time of peace. What profit have he that worketh in that wherein he labored? I have seen the travail which God has given to the sons of men to be exercised against. He has made everything beautiful in his time. Also, he has set the world in their heart, so that no man can find out the work that God made from the beginning to the end. Well, the last, I know that there is no good in them but for a man to rejoice and to do good in his sight. Thanks be to God for the reading of his holy word.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Thank you very much, sis, for that wonderful word. There's a time for everything. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. That is why.
Nice. Send the partners. See. Yeah. And what went wrong?
Some glad morning when this life is over.
Thank you.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
No, I am sick too.
Anybody who helped that man form his or her neighbor has somebody with drugs.
Yes.
And not only who lives beside must know it. Far out, many times you see with this bag going away, he is going to look for his family or friends down that wrong time. He is obedient and orderly all the way, all when he's going to go from his job. Well put together.
Amen. Yes.
Yes.
Amen.
Well put together. No, chaka. Well put together.
That's right.
He was encouraging. Let me tell you something. They have not come in. And when their father died, if you said it's something like a guy, you know what was done at school. He's gone to my mom's nowhere, going to teach him. Yes. And I love him for that because that was a guy. I know that his heart is bleeding today. Very encouraging person. Always ready to give good encouragement to people, especially young people. Oh, don't know what is it, meaning? Encouragement, sweet labor. Loving, even when it is impossible to love everyone what he should love. He is a brother, a banker in his own way.
Yes.
Brilliant person. He would help those in need of help financially.
Yes.
If you go to that man, if he don't say yes, he will have it to do.
Right.
He's a laborer. Worked very hard for his family. Good attention. Listener. And easy to understand. Lazy was not in his category. If you live in the year of brothers, you almost would have a friend. And it was work for your life. He was so ambitious. Very ambitious man. Had never had any problem with the Lord. You know, you were fully told that you can't see it. He was a very kind person. Share whatever he had to those in need, far and near. Entertainer in his way. When football, cricket, race horse, and other sports was in his favor. That whenever one seemed that the way he was, it was. He would hear him making his noise to the crowd of him. And when he made up his friends, what love they like him, he would do their way of entertaining themselves together. Master, well, God gave you this kind of deposit, you would have been in the crowd. You are to be. May God.
Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord. Thank you. Thank you. During this year, last year, one of the things that I keep saying, a lot of the good people are dying.
Yes.
Now, it is sad. And what I hope is that all of us that are in the reach of my voice and those of us who go to different funeral and would have heard of person who died and was a good person, that we take something from that person.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm going to take away today?
It's the EP.
Did you take care of the banana?
Yes.
Take care of it.
Yes.
And I want you to look at that. It's very deep.
Yes.
Very, very deep. Amen?
Yes.
Amen. Sometimes we take care, sometimes we do some good to some people out there.
Yes.
And you don't know that this is very same person will come around and assist you later on.
Yes.
Take care of the banana,
yes.
And you will take care of it.
Yes.
Amen?
Yes.
this time we'll have a selection by the Nightingale Grove Baptist Church Choir.
Girl, let me in front of nobody.
Yeah.
Have you counted the cost? It's a question that all would have to answer for their personal self. Amen?
Yes.
Amen. This time we'll have a song of meditation, Casting Crowns.
Live on and on. The roses never. Amen. Graham Wright who said that he was no nonsense person. I always said to folks, don't pay attention to him twice when he's solemn and in peace. He has a very tender heart, same as Noel. He would make up him peace in on him. What is the softest person inside you can think of? Remember one time my goat went into masquerade room. And the man who now wants nobody apart from anybody who work in here passing. Master Noel, come, Pastor! Pastor! I said, yes, Pastor Noel, what happened now? Pastor! We get tired of opening up! We get tired of going up! We can't have over there much of the ground! And I felt so bad. And, you know, I said, alright, Master Noel, I'm very sorry. Fine. The best thing I can do, because I don't want to go to destroy everyone, the best thing I can do is just sell it. He said, no, sir. Matthew 25 verse 1 says, then shall the kingdom of heaven be likened unto 10 virgins, which took their lamps and went forth to meet the bridegroom. 5 of them were wise, and 5 were foolish. They that were foolish took their lamps and took no oil with them. But the wise took oil in their vessels with their lamps. While the bridegroom tarried, they all slumbered and slept. And at midnight there was a cry made, behold, the bridegroom cometh, go ye out to meet him. Then all those virgins arose and trimmed their lamps. And the foolish said unto the wise, give us of your oil, for our lamps are gone out. But the wise answered, saying, not so, lest there be not enough for us and you. But go ye rather to them that sell and buy for yourselves. While they went to buy, the bridegroom came, and they that were ready went in with him to meet to the marriage, and the door was shut. Afterward came also the other virgins, saying, Lord, Lord, open to us. But he answered and said, verily, I say unto you, I know you not. Watch therefore, for ye know neither the day nor the hour wherein the Son of Man cometh. These are some thoughts I want to remind us of in this funeral service. Some years ago, I was in the United States, and I was in, you know, Ypsilanti, Michigan. I was, you know, preaching 1 week at the church there, and at the end of the week, some of the brethren, some of the men from the church decided that we are going to go to a movie. So we went for a movie, and the movie was Pearl Harbor. Anybody ever watch that? Get a chance, watch it. Pearl Harbor. That is when the Japanese bombed Pearl Harbor in the United States. And they did it unawares. Yeah. They attacked the United States and they did not expect it. 2010. It's 2011, 9/11? Yes. I was in the United States also in Maryland. That was in Pastor Top's kitchen. And he came in and said, have you heard what happened in New York, brother? I said, no, sir, what happened? He said, go look at the TV now. So I looked at the TV just to see the second plane going into the tower. And America was attacked. They didn't expect it. Yeah? Everything shut down. Everything. Well, we do not know when Christ is going to come, do you? No. Do not know. But it seems as if people are taking it for granted. Because some say, why, from the day of the bond, the years that Jesus will come, and he can't come yet. But just remember that he doesn't work according to our clock. The Bible says he's coming again. Yeah. The Bible says he's coming again. So it doesn't matter whether you hear it from the day you were born or you're just hearing it now, he is coming again. Because the Bible said so. And I believe the Bible, and the Bible is true. Yeah. Here's another thing. thing that you need to bear in mind. Death is coming. And I do not know who the next, I don't know if it is I who the next or anybody else. None of us know. But it can come at any time. So it doesn't matter if you want to look strong and healthy now. If death come knocking on our doors, then it's time for us to go. It behooves us therefore to prepare ourselves. Brethren, prepare ourselves. It is not known to anyone. Now I want us to look very briefly in this passage of scripture. On these 10 virgins, there were some things that they had in common. Yeah. Some common factors among them. Notice they were all called virgins. Right now, when you think of a virgin, you're thinking of a, you know, a lady, and more so a lady who is untouched. Yeah. And which suggests to me moral uprightness. Because there are some people who will say, well, may I live better life than someone in a church, and they can't come tell me, no. You heard it, right? Yeah. And they think that they are so right. But my Bible says, but we are all as an unclean thing, and all are wrong, fade away as a leaf. We all fade as a leaf, and our iniquities like the wind have taken us away. Yeah. So they all had lamps, which suggests to me the word of God. Nobody inside here is a stranger to the word of God. Yeah? The Bible, a Bible that has been, you know, coming under attack and threat for hundreds of years now, but cannot be destroyed. Every single one of us, if I'm not mistaken, every household that is represented here have at least one Bible in it. Yeah? All have their lamp. The Bible says, thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. Yeah? They all slumbered and slept, for the foolish it might suggest a false sense of security, my dear friends. But for those who know Jesus Christ as Savior, it suggests genuine security and confidence and rest in the Lord. All of them slumbered and slept. They expected, all of them expected the bridegroom to come. But they did not know the hour. There are some who will have the audacity to say that the Christians are wasting their time. Yeah? But if it were so, does that give
peace and safety.
But may I say to you, my dear friend, when you think that way, sudden destruction comes. Oh,
who are not saved, my dear friends, and we have some bad singers who are saved. Yeah. We have some seemingly good people in the world. And so you think that it's okay for you to live the way you are living, my dear friends. May I say to you, even though you may have some things in common like the Christians, just remember that everybody is going to give an account to God one day. But there are some contrasts between these two groups. Yeah. Five are wise. Five are foolish. Five are wise and five are foolish. What of the foolish? The foolishness of these five virgins consisted in their lack of personal preparation. That was the foolishness. Lack of personal preparation. Are you hearing me today?
Yes.
Lack of personal preparation. They took no oil with them. Even though they had lamps. But they never had any oil in their vessels. That means they were not prepared. They were careless. Not forward thinking. Not forward looking. Guilty of inexcusable senseless neglect. Yeah. So are a lot of us. Yeah. Never had the necessary ingredient, my dear friends, with which to sustain their flame. They never had that. They were not prepared to meet the bridegroom. Amos continues to thunder in our ears, my friends. Prepare to meet thy God. Prepare to meet thy God. Because one of these days he'll come.
Yes.
Yes, he'll come. As a torch without fuel is worthless, so is a profession without relationship. A lot of people claim that they're Christian. You know, one time you used to think that Jamaica is a Christian country. Not so anymore. Jamaica is no Christian country. Are you hearing me? And America is no Christian country. Canada is no Christian country. And England is no Christian country. We're wicked and bad and vile and senseless. And only Jesus Christ can make the difference. And if Jamaica does not repent, Jamaica is going to suffer great. If the people of Nightingale Grove don't repent, Nightingale is going to suffer great loss. And if the people of New Market don't repent, New Market is going to suffer great situation that they will not even have time to fight. Yeah. Where were you looking? Man must repent. Yeah. Man must get prepared. Prepare to meet thy God. Yeah. Man can only show a form of godliness for a time. You hear me? You can only show a form of godliness for a time. But one of these days it shall be known. One of these days, my dear friends, going to be revealed. You can only pretend for so long and no more. One of these days you are going to face the harsh reality of death. Yeah, one of these days. You can pretend for so long and no more, whether during this lifetime or after, that he was only pretending. It's going to be known. It's going to be known. Yeah. Foolish! Foolish! Foolish. Don't be so foolish today. Prepare to meet God. Prepare to meet God. Yeah. Then what of the wise? Be like the wise. They took oil in their vessels with them. Yeah. They were prepared and ready for the bridegroom at any time. Are you with me?
Yes.
They're prepared for the bridegroom at any time. They have not outward but inward possession.
You must do that.
Why were these virgins so foolish? Huh? They completely disregarded the oil until this critical moment. Just like some of you are disregarding the word of God until it's too late. You young people that are wasting your time, you think, say, I have a whole lot of time before you make a sad mistake. Young people are dead now like flies. Yeah. One time you used to be pure old people, but you're dead. No. The young dying more than old be dying. So you think that you have a lot of time? You make a sad mistake. Yeah. You are waiting until the critical moment. You may not even have time to say, Jesus, have mercy. Yeah, driving on the road, accident, bah, death. Walking on the street, man decides, ever come take everything I have, and just put it under your ears, and bam, you're gone. Yeah. You probably get sick too, so that your mind goes and you can't even think. Yeah, anything can happen. Anything can happen. Don't you see that how important it is for you to be prepared to meet God? Yeah. Foolish action has no sensible explanation. So you can't tell God, say, boy, this and that. And probably you tell God, say, are you neighbor? And we couldn't live good with them for that. And then people that don't grow up church never good. And then people out of that church are never good. And then people, yeah, you make a sad mistake. You make a sad mistake. Yeah. You can't give God that type of excuse there. The question would be if somebody says, what have you done with my son? He died for your sins. He pleaded with you. He even lived to make intercession for you. But you did not even respond to him. Would it be that this is a picture, my friends, of what it will be when Jesus comes? Yeah. It is an established fact that he's coming again. Yeah. The Bible says, Jesus looked at his disciples that were so destroyed. He says, let not your heart be troubled. You believe in God? Believe also in me. In my Father's house, I'm in mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again. And Jesus said that, you know me. I will come again. Yeah. When he was taken up from them to heaven, my dear friend, two men dressed in white apparel standing nearby, noticing the distraught disciples gazing into heaven. They said, ye men of Galilee, why stand you gazing into heaven? This same Jesus, which is taken up from you into heaven, shall so come in like manner as you've seen go. Paul caught the picture in 1 Thessalonians chapter 4. He says, from the Lord himself shall descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of the angels and the trump of God, and the dead in Christ shall rise first. Then we who are alive and remain shall be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air. So shall we ever be with the Lord. Yeah. Don't know when. The Bible says two men will be in the field, one taken and the other left. Two women grinding at the mill, one taken and the other left. Two shall be in bed, one taken and the other left. What's there for you? Do not know, whatever. The Lord is coming. Yeah, you don't know when he's coming. He's coming for those who are wise. He's coming for the born again believers. The born again believers. Those who have made a personal profession of faith, those who identify themselves with Jesus Christ, those who are blood washed, those who know him, not only know about him, but know him. They're the ones he's coming for. Yeah. The Bible says, they that were ready went in with him to the mountain. Those who were ready. You can't say, hold on to Jesus. Maybe go put things right with the neighbor. Hold on to Jesus. Maybe go apologize. Hold on to Jesus. Maybe go fling with a Bible we have in the. Hold on to Jesus. Maybe go tear off the harsh room from the door. It may be that you will be called over hell, but at that time it will be too late.
Amen.
Too late!
Amen.
Weeping will not save me, though my eyes were bathed in tears. That could not allay my fears, could not wash the sins of the earth. Weeping will not save me. The harvest is past, the summer is in. My soul is not saved. The Bible says when they went out to buy oil to get prepared, it was too late. When they came back, the door was shut. The door was shut. You remind me of Noah when building the ark. Nobody paid me any mind. God said, I don't believe so, brother. Oh, just like me, some of we never believe so, hurricane will come because we never believe in a hurricane. We never see it yet, and when Gilbert struck at that time, everybody ran up. Even though we were warned! Yeah, but Noah, poor Noah lived for so long, and it could be that they were mocking Noah. And they were saying all sorts of things and criticizing Noah. Oh, foolish you are to be building up when you never see rain yet. I must see dread and you have a seal and the ark upon and all sorts of something. But the time came when the flood occurred. Yeah, you want to hear them knocking upon the door of the ark because it is God who shut the door. Of God shut the door. Poor Noah, his heart must have given way. If Noah had the chance, Noah would save him. But then I might shut the door. And he never had the key. Yeah. You think that when Jesus Christ come and say, time up! Your mother and father can say, hold on, Jesus, may have one son down there when I see him. Have one daughter down there when I see him. Hold on, Jesus, may have some people we need to tell. What will your answer be? What will your answer be? Don't let the door shut by you. Are you hearing me?
Yes.
Don't let the door close on you. Give Jesus a chance now. You say, Pastor, how do I do that? The Bible says, for all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. The Bible says, for the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ, our Lord. The Bible says, that if thou shalt confess with thy mouth Jesus as Lord, and believe in thine heart that God raised him from the dead, thou shalt be saved. For with the heart man believeth unto righteousness, and with the mouth confession is made unto salvation. And for whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. You hear any baptism mentioned there, sir? And even if you go by the book of Acts, you'll realize if you analyze the thing first, and I'll suggest that you baptize can't get you. Now baptism can't save nobody, church membership can't save nobody, your good works can't save nobody, because the Bible says, for by grace are you saved through faith, and then not of yourself. It is the gift of God, not of works, that any man should boast. All rest in Jesus Christ, and he is willing and ready now to save you. Will you then say in your heart, Lord Jesus, I realize that I need to be prepared. Forgive me of my sins, Lord, and come into my heart and save me. That I'll walk with you. I'll serve you. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Be wise, my friends. You can't lose.
Shall we praise the Lord?
Praise the Lord.
Shall we praise the Lord?
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord. Just before, when I thank the great trouble for the word. But right here in the midst is a question that you will have to ask yourself. And I asked myself when Pastor Rome was preaching. And I answered the question, what if I was the one? It's a question that you have to ask yourself. And only you can answer it. But what if you are here, you're saying, Pastor, I'm not sure. I'm willing to help you and to share with you. With your heads bowed and your eyes closed, we're going to pray, and then right afterwards we're going to have the eulogy by Sister Stevenson. Or maybe you're here and you're saying, Pastor, I'm not a Christian. If I wasn't one line in this casket, I would not go to heaven. You're saying, Pastor, pray for me. Nobody looking around. They're looking around. It's time for you to make a decision for your own self. Are you going to allow Jesus to come and there is no oil in your lamp? Will you just raise that hand, Pastor, pray for me? Yes, I see that. God bless you. Nobody looking around. Is there one more? You're not saved. If you were lying in this casket today, where would you spend your long journey? Some of you grew up in church, but you walked away. And Pastor Bowen said it very clear that the church can't, only Jesus can. But you're saying, Pastor, pray for me. Father, I thank you for my who identify herself that if she was lying in this casket, God, she would know exactly where she would be. But God, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, I pray that even now, before she leave here, God, that Father in heaven, she will know. May the power that you have invested in us that are called your name, help to guide her, help to lead her to you. And Father, I pray this, Father in heaven, not only for her, but for others, maybe they are afraid. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, God, I know that heaven is real. I know that hell is real. And I know that one day that you're going to come again. And I pray, God, that your people will be ready. So help us. Those that are in the reach of my voice that are not sure, help them. God, we honor you for this. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Amen. Sister Stevenson will come with the eulogy, family friend.
Started to do farming along with his father.
and later embraced that vocation as his means of livelihood. He at intervals did day's work with one Isaac Marshall for the then tidy sum of 3 shillings per day. As time passed, he expanded in his vocation and did mixed crop farming and cattle rearing. Farmers around sold their choice animals to Master Noel, who in turn raised them well and was able to get the best price for these animals. His parents accommodated him for a while at their place, during which time his eye caught the attention of the petite and attractive Carol, old Carol as he called her. Still at his parents' house, young Carol was now in the early stage of pregnancy. Noel became very uncomfortable with the arrangement and moved to the other property where their present home stands. He went away to America on the farmer program, leaving Carol's mother to assist in her care. While still in America, his son Alan was born. He was ecstatic and informed Carol that he should be named Alan Alfonso. He could not wait for the 9 months contract to end so he could be home to his sweetheart and his young son. The couple tied the knot on the 9th of January, 1965. The groom wanted the wedding to be commemorated on his birthday on the 14th. But because of circumstances then, they instead went for the earlier date and had almost a week-long honeymoon. Travel to the United States continued from the 60s into the 70s, after which the man, as Sister Taverna called him, decided to stay with his well-established family in their own state. All had children, 4 of which were born there. Mr. Blake had a daily routine that he stuck to for the entire working life. He was out of his house every morning before 6 a.m., headed for his huge farm in the rugged hills called Mount Olivet. And if you look to my left, Mount Olivet is situated beyond that hill. He was not here for sightseeing, although the view from that lofty perch was breathtaking. Asked why he rose so early in the morning, his answer was, early to bed, early to rise, makes a man strong, healthy, and wise. This Trojan of a man was there to tend his animals and to work like 10 well-oiled machines on his farm for a full 8 hours, where he grew the best farm products of the day. His wife used to accompany him to the farm in the early days, but found that she could not physically keep pace with him, as nerve problems called a halt to her routine. Mas Noel continued the sale of his animals and crops. He had choice animals, and this sale grew by leaps and bounds. In the evening, in his familiar style, he would call, "Oh, Carol, we have a cold money." His cashier wife would put away their earnings until he was ready to go to the bank with it. Brother Noel possessed some very admirable traits. He was a wizard at figures. Whether it was pound, shilling, or pence, or dollars and cents, he was an astute businessman, dynamic in keeping records and saving where it mattered most. He was quick to tell you, study vision, beat education.
All right.
No matter how much academic qualification one has, it is in applying this principle that really makes us succeed.
Yes.
Mas Noel's independence and self-reliance and the dedication to his vocation was the guest that kept his engine running throughout his life. He often said he wasn't depending on his children for anything. He cared for them and assisted them that they grasped as much education as they could. They could miss school, and Brother Alan over there can tell you of an incident where he decided that, you know, he was late for school, so he was going to stay until half day. The then Miller saw poor Alan at the gate and called the Master Norris' attention. He came over and went up, collected Alan, placed him in front of him, and took him right up to the Miller. Hear her coming. That's the gentleman.
Yes.
I don't think I would do the same. I would call Alan myself and keep him and say, let it happen. But you know his name. They couldn't miss school unless they were very ill. They participated in family chores, which included, as somebody said, watering the cows, going to the field for the food, and this instilled in them the value of hard and honest labor. He graciously accepted the gifts they gave him, but was never in need of handouts. He was a proud man and was able to hold his own.
Yes.
His wife Carol's desire was always for him to accept Christ. And through years of praying, both as an individual and soliciting prayers from the brethren on his behalf, Brother Noel walked forward in church and accepted Christ. This event brought tears of joy from our sister as well as the brethren. He desired to be baptized, but was advised against this event due to health issues. His attendance to church was now more regular. Whenever he was able. He was devastated when he was advised by his doctor to scale down his farming activities. He by now was quite self-reliant and fully able to take care of his financial obligations. A few weeks before he passed, in his usual style, he called, "Oh Carol, when we did, we want them to take care of the best care of you, and nobody can take you out away. We love you." He was very kind to many persons. He would share his produce with these persons. I recall many times I received quality products up until the week when he passed. If I didn't pass the house quickly enough, he would send butcher or whoever he saw, and he would make sure I had the last bit of yam just the week before he died. He had a unique way of ending our conversations on the phone. Sister Blessum, have a good balance of the day. His family members laughed and regarded his coming as foolishness. I understood him perfectly. A part of the day had gone, so what was left was the balance of the day. He was so right.
Yes.
He was a very good converser. Who could discuss topics from religion to current affairs, sports, and any matter at hand. He shared a respectful relationship with business partners, and you can see evidence of that.
Yes.
Bankers and wherever he went, he was always neatly dressed, shirt tucked in, and his belt.
Yes.
Take a pallet and an anchor.
Yes.
Brother Noel was a romantic at heart. With Christmas approaching, he would say, "Oh Carol,
yes,
I feel it's time I come up now." To which she would ask, "What do you mean?" He would answer, "No Carol, not Carol then, and the first Noel." I didn't know how they celebrated this event. Maybe you could ask Sister Carol. She disclosed. After visiting several doctors over the last few years, his conditions remained unstable. Barney was now seriously curtailed, and he never could quite relate to his new normal. He would still be up, and a few weeks ago, he would collect his book and texter, meaning his machete and his pal, which Hamery named them that way, and climb the hill to tend the animals. The Wednesday before he passed, his wife could hear him humming the song, "Precious Jesus, hold my hand." In the early hours of Thursday, October 20, 2022, after missing him for too long, she found him responsive, and with yeoman strength, she assisted him until he drew his last breath. Shock and disbelief set in as she called for help, and neighbors came to comfort and console her. Brother Noel lived beyond 84 years. His face mirrored sweet peace, which we are assured is now his. His dedication to duty for his family is priceless. Left to celebrate a legacy of love, honor, and respect, even as they grieve their irreparable loss, are his wife of 57 years, Harold. Children, Alan, Paulette or Joy, Catherine or Sharon, Joyce or Marcia, and Conroy or Mark. Grandchildren, great-grandchildren, brother Everton, sons-in-law, daughters-in-law, brothers-in-law and other relatives, nephews, cousins, and friends. May God's perpetual light illuminate his soul.
Thank you very much, Sister Stephen. At this time, we have prayer for the bereaved family. This is done by Yvonne Simi.
Edward.
Envoy.
Edward. Thank you.
Envoy.
Bless the Lord. Reverend, I ask your permission just to join in singing near the chorus, the chorus of Peace of God. Covering. I believe this afternoon you need the covering of God's Holy Spirit on your lives. So I'm going to ask for it just to join me.
Oh.
Lord, wash me, and I shall be washed.
abiding in snow, you are willing and able to accept such a person this afternoon. God, I pray that you will bless your children. Help them to know that you, God, will keep them in your perfect peace, whose mind is stayed on thee. Cover them, Lord Jesus. Cover them in the name of Jesus. We thank you, God, for hearing our prayers this afternoon. I give them over to you, and I pray that you will continue to supply all their needs according to your riches and glory by Christ Jesus. Bless your children now. In Jesus' name I pray and tell you thanks. And all God's people say,
amen.
Amen. Amen. Praise God.
Just leave them at the first here.
Let us all stand here.